The RV Show USA is brought to you by Flagstaff, building better RVs, making smarter RVers.
I'm all right. From PPL Motorhomes on our guest line is its president, known by RVers around the country as RV Nana. Now, if you didn't know any better, you may think, "Oh, RV Nana, how cute. Must be some little old lady." And if that's what you're thinking, you'll be thinking wrong. Diana LeBlanc-Link is a grandma, but she is also one incredibly smart businesswoman. And Diana and her team have built an RV consignment business that I don't believe anybody, she and her team have built this business, I don't think anybody will ever be able to reach them. Diana joins us here on the show quite often, but she has been absent recently. How's everything going, young lady?
Oh, I'm glad to be on the show. I've missed you guys.
Likewise, we've missed you. So I need your help with something. I want to jump right in.
Okay.
The other day, speak with this guy, and he's trying to buy a used RV from another individual. Used RV, the buyer needs to borrow money to buy the RV. The seller owes money on the RV. The problem is the bank that is holding the lien doesn't want to let go of that lien until they get paid off, but the bank that is loaning the money on the RV to purchase doesn't want to loan the money until they have the title in their hand, and it seems like a stalemate, Diana. What's going on?
Welcome to the world of a disastrous opportunity. I mean, just it's going to be a horrible nightmare because the bank may be, the lien holder may be on the West Coast somewhere, and you're dealing with some number, some computer. You have a banker that's on the East Coast that you've chosen to finance your RV through, your new RV through, and you're right. It's a stalemate. They can't get together. This is where, and I'm not going to tout PPL as being your savior on this, but we step in and we go after the buyer comes in and we know that they are paying for the vehicle. We have our draft. We have whatever the down payment is. We pay off that lien for the customer who's selling it. And our position is we deliver a clear and marketable title to our buyer. So that means we're paying off the lien, but then we've got to send it. You have to register the vehicle, then send what they call the white slip, the registration form, to that new lender. And it can be real convoluted.
Why isn't it as simple as buying a vehicle, Diana? I mean,
it would be the same thing with a car. You're buying a car from an individual, and if they have a lien, how do you know that this person's really going to be trusted that this is all going to be taken care of? That banker isn't going to give you $20,000, $30,000, $40,000 or more until they know they're going to have a title. The banker isn't going to give you the title until they know they have their certified funds. So
that's why somebody in the middle, like a PPL, you're the bridge that puts those deals together. And to me, I mean, this guy, he seriously wants to buy this RV. It's a good RV. He wants to buy it. Mm-hmm. But he's like, I can't do anything because the bank won't give me the money and the seller can't get the title. And anyway, go ahead.
I was going to say, I will say that there are some bankers, especially if you're dealing with a smaller bank, you can go in. You and both parties will go in together to whoever the bank is that's financing for that buyer. And that bank will execute the documents to pay off the lien. You know, they'll do all of the different things where you just need to have somebody that's neutral in the middle that's responsible for both parties.
I got you. You know, we could go off on that on a tangent, but I think that was really good to know because I think it's probably a very common problem, isn't it?
No, you know, it is a problem because I'm going to say that 55% of the vehicles that we sell have a lien. Now, that doesn't mean they're upside down on them, but they have a lien that has to be satisfied to be able to sell the vehicle.
Wow. All right, listen, change of directions here. Last weekend, some friends of mine that have a show up in New England did a video on how many people are changing their travel plans, and they're looking at RVing as a safe and fun way to stay close to home and build memories. And are you seeing anything like that happening down here in Texas?
We are. We are seeing some people. I had the nicest couple. Their family was planning a trip to Italy, And they were going in May, and they, several things, not just the stuff that's happening right now in the news, but several things seemed to get in the way of them all being able to get to Italy. So they decided to buy two, not just one RV. Two of the family members bought RVs.
Wow.
And they're going on an RV adventure. You know,
really?
That's what the lifestyle is all about. You know?
That is so cool. You know, because I think, I mean, it's tragic what's going on, you know. I mean, it will work itself out. But in the meantime, I think more people are discovering how cool camping and RVing is and spending that quality time with someone in close quarters, because so many wonderful memories can be made camping and RVing.
Oh, so many more than you can ever have in a hotel. You know, my favorite line is you never meet a lifelong friend in a hotel. You know, you're going to meet them when you're out camping.
Yeah, hey, let me ask you about the first-time buyer that comes up to PPL, and how do many of those buyers that they're looking for a travel trailer, do they even know they can tow, or do you have to?
No.
Tell me
no.
about that.
They don't. I've actually had people come in with a little, you know, I drive a little Nissan Murano, and they'll have the Nissan Murano that has the hitch, and they think they're looking at a 30-foot travel trailer. And we're going, no, maybe that little tab out there you might be able to do. But they don't, and we educate them to do their homework. My salespeople are advised not to tell them what they can tow, but give them the direction they need to go to talk to the manufacturer of their truck or their car or that dealer and get that exact information about their vehicle. You know, you can have three of the exact same trucks, and some of them have extra equipment on them that they can tow more than another one does.
Absolutely right. And that is so important. I see people all the time, you know, at Big Cheap. They'll come in and their truck's sagging in the back. And say, well, the salesman told me we could tow it. Well, they're towing it, but it's not really recommended, and it's probably quite a bit overweight. So do your homework first. Now, I know you talk with a lot of first-time buyers. You see a lot of them, that, like at your recent Tuesday Tips event. Are they all across the board? Are there more retirees, more younger people? What are you seeing?
Oh, my gosh, they are all across the board. I am seeing people as young as in their 20s and early 30s and all the way up into their 70s and 80s. But I'm seeing more of them now that are younger, and they're excited about this new way of life. They want to get out. They want to be connected. They don't want to lose that connection to Wi-Fi and all that, but they also want to disconnect and get some R&R away from that laptop, that office.
Talk with me about, you know, I always tell people to take their time, don't make an emotional decision. It's hard to not be emotional because it's so exciting to go RV shopping and to buy one. What sounds easy does hard, but try to not be emotional and take your time. At PPL, you guys don't mind. I mean, you don't even have a salesperson. You just kind of point them out there. If they want to stay for 2 hours, they can stay for 2 hours in an RV, right?
Right. We have sales representatives who are there to answer any questions for you, but they aren't going to have to direct you around on the lot. You have our dealerships are all open to where the vehicles are unlocked during the day. You get to wander through at your leisure. There's signs posted in each one of the vehicles that tell what the price is. We want you to lay on that bed, sit on that couch, figure out if you're going to get a crick in your neck when you're trying to watch TV. Can you stand up in the shower? The same things that really make a difference. And, you know, there's little things that happen. We took our maiden voyage this weekend in the Airstream, and I was like, oh, my gosh, I'm going to have the hairdryer problem.
Uh-oh.
We solved it. We bought a mirror for the door, you know?
Yeah.
That's all I can do.
All right. Listen, we got to let you go, Diana, but great information, and we'll talk to you again real soon, okay?
All right, good
deal.
You guys have a great week.
Thank you. All right, that's Diana from PPO Motorhomes. She always has some great advice for folks that RV already and folks who are just getting started. If you'd like to do a little online shopping, maybe online dreaming about RVs, all you got to do is go to their website. You'll see hundreds of them there. It's a great website, I'm telling you. PPLMotorhomes.com. Their inventory changes every single day. PPLMotorhomes.com. I'll be right back.